Now, today I'm going to be talking to you about some of my memories from secondary school. If you finished secondary school like me, I hope it brings back some memories, some nostalgia. But if you're still in secondary school, I hope you can just relate. And yeah, let's go. One of the worst things about secondary school was walking in the hall after you've got changed for PE and you realise that it's bleep test day. No! If you don't know what the bleep test is, it's this horrific test of aerobic fitness where you have to run up and down the sports hall every time this beep goes off and it gets faster and faster. And me, as a child, I was chubby and unhealthy, so this was my idea of complete hell. You walked into the hall and saw you were doing the bleep test that day. You wish you'd skived. You wish you'd stayed off. It was horrific. Nothing worse than bleep test day. There was always a couple of kids in every year who'd like deal sweets out as if they were drugs. They'd buy these weird toxic waste things at the shop for like a pound for a tub, and then they'd sell them for like a pound each per sweet. They are the entrepreneurs of the world, seriously. On the last day of year 11, it was absolutely compulsory for everyone to get their shirt signed by every man, woman and child in that school. If your shirt didn't have everyone's signatures on with some funny, strange little message, then your last day of year 11 was just a failure. I don't know if it was just our school, but there was always that one girl who absolutely loved horses. This girl would have like a horse backpack, horse pencil case, would go horse riding after school, pictures on Facebook with horses, chill out about the horses. In English lessons, all I remember is the English teacher always overanalyzing what the text said. For example, the author could say something like, "The curtains were blue," but the English teacher would be like, "The curtains represent his immense depression and lack of will to carry on, which juxtaposes with his love for the main female character on their journey towards companionship." No. What the author meant is that the curtains were blue. In PE lessons, when you had outdoor PE, and it was absolutely lashing it down, like thunder and lightning, it's pretty much flooded. But your PE teacher's like, "Of course we're still doing cross country, it's only a shower." Yeah, you've got like a massive waterproof jacket on with waterproof trousers and wellies. I'm here in my PE shorts and t-shirt and you're expecting me to go out there and do cross country? I don't think so. Chewing gum. If you had a packet of chewing gum and you let onto the class that you had a packet, everyone would be swarming towards you asking, "Can I have a bit of chewy?" No, this is my chewing gum. Leave me alone. But because chewing gum was banned, the way to eat it in class, if you were a genius, was to pretend to cough. That's the genius way to get chewing gum into your mouth. And there you have some of my secondary school memories. If you could relate to any of them, make sure to give this video a great big thumbs up. And make sure you subscribe for new videos every single Monday. Thank you very, very much for watching. I shall see you next time. Goodbye! It is unreal. Oh my god, pie. I love pie.